Hello everyone. In this part of the presentation, we are going to see in detail about the final procedures, that is the cleaning, inspecting and desensitizing the tooth preparation. This is the final part of an 11-part series on fundamentals of tooth preparation. We have already finished about the initial stage of tooth preparation, and in the final stage we have finished the four steps, and the final procedure is the cleaning, inspecting and desensitizing the tooth preparation. Why we are supposed to do this is, after preparing the cavity or the tooth preparation, there can be the debris which have accumulated because of the rotary cutting action. There can be some smear layers, or there can be some of the tooth particles which are cut and which is not yet removed. If this material is retained without removing, what happens is there will not be an adequate bonding of the restorative material to that of the tooth. So in order to prevent this and to enhance an intimate contact with the restorative material with the tooth, we have to clean and inspect. And finally, we have to desensitize so that there will be no postoperative sensitivity. First, we have to clean the cavity with water. Water is a good agent that we commonly use for cleaning the cavity. So we can use the water from the three-way syringe, and we have to remove the excess water. While drying the cavity, we should use a cotton pellet. If we are using a air from the three-way syringe, this pressurized blast of air can lead to the escape of the odontoblast through the dentinal tubules, or indirectly we can say that the odontoblast will be lost or it will be destroyed. So in order to avoid that, we should never use air from the three-way syringe while we are drying the prepared tooth. Always use a take a small cotton pellet, place it inside the tooth preparation, wait for some time, then we have to remove it. Even if you are using a rubber dam isolation, or we are doing whatever the type of isolation protocol we are following, we should still use a dry cotton pellet for drying the cavity. Okay, the next is, we have to disinfect the tooth preparation. So there can be some residual bacteria which are lying, or there may be some contaminant from the saliva which is sticking over the tooth surface while doing the tooth preparation or after the tooth preparation. And before doing the restoration, the cavity should be made sterile and as clean as possible. In order to disinfect the cavity preparation, we can use the 2% chlorhexidine solution. Chlorhexidine is a very good antibacterial agent which will destroy the bacteria or any pathogens which are present over there. And the final stage, or the final step in the last stage, is the use of desensitizers to desensitize the tooth preparation. We can use the desensitizer for non-bonded restoration, for example a cast mat restoration, if you are using zinc phosphate as the loading cement, or if you are using an amalgam restoration. In those situations we can use desensitizers. And for all bonded restorations, for example, if you are using a resin cement to bond an indirect restoration, or if you are using a composite restoration, then those situations we can use dentin bonding agent as a desensitizing agent that will limit the post-operative sensitivity. There is something called as the immediate dentin sealing. Immediate dentin sealing is a procedure in which immediately after tooth preparation, we have to apply a bonding agent and it has to be cured. Especially this is practiced in case of indirect restoration. For example, if you are doing a cast gold restoration, we will make the tooth preparation and make the impression, and we are going to temporize it. And in this temporary time frame, the tooth may have some sensitivity. In order to prevent this, we can immediately seal the dentinal tubules with a bonding agent. So that's also a good practice which can be practiced even for full coverage restorations. For desensitizing, For example, for amalgam restoration, we can use 5% glutaraldehyde and 35% HEMA, that is 2-hydroxyethyl methacrylate. So HEMA is also the primer which is used in the bonding agents. And for the bonded restorations, we can use the conventional bonding agent which contains the primer and also the adhesive. So thus we have come to the end of the last step in the fundamentals of tooth preparation, which is the final procedure of cleaning, inspecting and desensitizing the tooth preparation. So we can clean with water and then we can disinfect with chlorhexidine. Then we have to desensitize for amalgam restoration, or we can apply a bonding agent for a composite restoration. Finally, we have to inspect the tooth preparation if there is something visible and if something which is loose material which are available which have to be removed. So that's all about this step in the tooth preparation. Thus, we have come to the end of the 11-part series of Fundamentals of Tooth Preparation. I will put the link for all the parts in the description. So just watch it, and I hope that this series is useful for all the students. Thank you. Stay tuned. Happy for you watching this video. Have a nice day.